welcome to the Rodrigue Carlson Fieldhouse for CTN's live coverage of girls high school basketball. The border battle, always packed with emotion when the Cardinals and Bengals meet. And a very good matchup between two teams, very similar records, similar results against like opponents.
Yeah, they have, and they're dealing with similar situations. Both teams dealing with some illnesses. Of course, the Cardinals are missing the Ackerman twins, who are on a cruise right now. So, but they've been dealing with some flu symptoms. Fortunately for Coon Rapids, all those girls, both those girls are back. Blaine, I don't believe, is so lucky on the other side. They're missing a couple of girls with strep throat. So it'll be an interesting test for the depth of both
benches.
And not
to mention the loss of that young lady right there, number 15 in sweats. Bonifo would have been their star player, but lost for the season to a knee injury.
She was good. I remember her from last season.
Here's your starting lineups. Carson, Honey, Erickson, Bohr, and Brian for the Bengals. Artis, Dixon, Hanneman, Hetwer, and Carver for Coon Rapids.
Well, keep your eye on Kayla Bohr for the Bengals, just a sophomore, but coach calls her such a hard working, calls her the workhorse of this team. And she's averaging a little over 11 points as she comes into the contest.
Three-pointer is up and off the mark for Hetwer. Recovered, tipped away by Hanneman, and she picks the pocket of Bohr.
Well, Lady Hanneman, another one of those players for Coon Rapids. If they want to win tonight, I think they're going to have to work their post game. She's going to have to be active underneath the basket, of course, along with Ellie Carver.
Bengals first look on offense. Erickson brings it back up top, watched by Artis. Cutting through the middle is Carson, back out for Brian. Thinks about it, now goes to the corner. Three-point attempt by Bohr comes up short. Dixon has the rebound, and she will run the floor for the Cardinals. Left side, Hanneman jump shot is good.
Yeah, that's nice. Lady Hanneman gets her first opportunity here. Puts the Cardinals on the board here early with an early 2-0 lead.
Erickson into the front court, looks right side for Garfield, back up top for Carson. That one off the hands of Erickson in the middle, able to force up his shot, but it won't go, and Carver has the rebound. Also with Carver and Hanneman, you have to own the inside, you have to own the glass with those two good tall players underneath.
Without a doubt, Joe, and that's something that you know, that Coach Peterson and I talked about. And I think the biggest key for the Cardinals tonight is you got to make buckets. You know, we talked on Sports Night. I watched their game against Irondale.
Trying to feed it to Ellie, going to the lane. She couldn't quite drag it in as Blaine was able to defend the pass well and turn it up court. Erickson now watched by Dixon on the right side. Cross court for Garfield. Back up top for Erickson. Three-pointer is on the way and good for Anna Garfield. And full court pressure from the Bengals.
That's Garfield's first three-pointer made this season. She came in 0 for 8.
Tried to hand off. It does get through to Hanneman and or Hewitt. And Carver hands it back to her. Hetwer, left side. Artis, open look from 15. It comes up just short. The rebound by Bohr. Lost the ball out of bounds. It'll be Coon Rapids basketball.
We'll watch Kayla Bohr tonight because we talked, our coach talked about her being the workhorse. She's very active underneath the basket as well.
Hanneman back inside to Carver, back out. Hetwer for three. This one's just short. Good position by Brian to get the board, and the Bengals want to push the pace. Hanneman back on defense to flex it away. Allows her teammates a chance to get back and set up in their defensive end.
And they want to be active on defense tonight. They want to make sure that they trouble the Bengals, as do the Bengals. They want to pressure Coon Rapids specifically tonight. They want to make them uncomfortable, take them out of their game.
Bohr had to reach for that one, able to drag it down. Erickson now will reset the offense. Right side for Garfield. Dixon tight on defense. Bryan's pass knocked away and nearly turned over by Dixon. And that's going to draw a foul as Erickson just took it hard to the lane. It's going to go against Destiny Artis.
That'll be the first foul of this game for either squad.
Looked underneath. Carver did get a piece of the pass as they were trying to get it to Erickson on the baseline. So Blaine with another chance to set up.
Cardinals coming off a 61-42 loss to the hands of Champlain Park.
Phoebe Carson had it swatted away by Hetwer, but recovers, and now Erickson to Bryan up top, underneath, all alone is Bohr, and a breakdown on defense. Quick timeout for the Cardinals.
Yeah, Coach Peterson not happy with that, as you called it, Joe. No communication on defense. Bohr all alone underneath the basket. Easy bucket for her. Now you're going to see everybody clear out, and her teammate spots her underneath. That's about an easy bucket as you're going to find.
She called everybody. Let them know, hey, they forgot about me. They got her the basketball. That's how it works.
And the Bengals coming off a loss of their own, 72-49 over Centennial beat them.
Centennial, top 10 team.
Yeah, they're good.
I think they're 6 or 7. Park Center with the upset over Maple Grove knocked the Crimson out of the top 10 and found their way into the top 10 themselves. So a lot of good competition up here in the Northwest.
Oh, there always is.
Dixon will get it in to Artis. Quickly double-teamed, and now Dixon across midcourt. Left side, Hetwer for three. And this time she hits it, and we're all tied up.
Nice job. She's able to spot up from the outside. Just her second varsity start.
And her mother,
Carly Hetwer, is a freshman,
I believe, sang the anthem.
She did. What a beautiful voice.
An amazing job.
Yeah. No.
Drive to the lane by Bohr will get her the foul. And get her to the line to shoot two. It's going to go against Hanneman.
That's going to be just the second team foul on Coon Rapids. Natalie Post checking in for Coon Rapids. She's also a freshman. She's going to fill in for Courtney Ackerman in terms of what Courtney does. She was a leading scorer and rebounder in that loss to Champlain Park.
She's got some length to her.
Yeah, she does.
Carver tracks down the rebound off the miss by Bohr. Artis on the right side of the offense for Coon Rapids. Goes down low to Post in the post. Good move. Can't get it to fall. Post, or Hanneman gets it back. Tried to shoot over Post. A foul underneath. Or did it just go out of bounds?
I think it went out of bounds. Yeah.
That's a lot of arms at the back of your defense with Carver, Post, and Hanneman all on the floor. Artisan Dixon at the top of the 2-3. Garfield thought about this shot. We'll kick it up top to Erickson instead. And Blaine being patient. Carson tried a little give and go, swatted away out of bounds by Carver.
Yeah, Carver smartly just stepped in front of the passing lane, able to get a piece of it.
Hetwer will check back in. Short breather for her, and Destiny Artis gets a chance to sit down for a moment. Garfield the inbound for the Bengals, gets it to Erickson in the left corner. Watched by Hetwer, steps inside, jump shot had way too much on it. Post can't control the rebound, it's out of bounds to the Bengals.
I like your positioning underneath the basket again, but just couldn't control the basketball to try and get possession.
Inbounded to Bohr up top. Bryan will give it back to Bohr. Right side, good move to the baseline by Garfield, but kicks it back up top to Erickson. Three-pointer by Bohr is short. Coming in for the rebound is Garfield, and now a scramble on the floor, a tie-up, and Blaine will maintain possession.
Well, Carver has to do a good job of getting position underneath the basket. She's got to be able to use her size to box out the opposition and be able to get a rebound.
Garfield up top, Carson for three. That one's good.
A nice spot up three for Carson. Carson averaging is about a little over 6 points a game. She's four of now, 5 of 12 from three. Some of the things that I was talking to Coach Peterson about, we talked about on sports night, was against Irondale, they had a lot of looks from inside. Second and third opportunities that they could not make fall, and that's something that Coach Peterson has been working on with her squad. We have to be able to finish at the basket. And that's been an issue so far this year.
Bengals working the perimeter. Out of the corner is Emily Bauer, up top for Bohr. Bohr will put it on the floor, kick it back out. Erickson, long two-pointer, hard off the back of the iron. Bohr gets the rebound. Hers will rattle around and down.
Yeah, again, no hesitation putting that basketball back up, and the Cardinals are going to turn the ball over. Bohr with 5 of the 11 points for the Bengals.
Erickson, watched by Hatwer, right side for Bauer. Carson back up top for Bryan, and now Erickson. Hatwer there with her defensively, able to put it on the floor with the left hand, ran into traffic and deflected out of bounds by Destiny Artis, so Bengals will get the ball again.
Not only is it youth night here at Roger E. Carlson, but it's also ugly sweater night. I don't know, where's your ugly sweater, Yen?
Quick hands by Hetworth, gets in and gets the steal, one-on-one against Erickson. Hands off to Carver, she's bumped and coughs it up. Controlling in the corner is Bauer, and now swings it around to Bryan, and now Bohr. Up top, Carson trying to get to the lane, and she traveled, trying to force that one through a couple of Cardinal defenders. Pass. Didn't get through, nicely stopped by Boris. Scramble, Hanneman has it, now tied up, and it'll be Cardinal basketball. Dixon will inbound from underneath the Bengal basket. Up top for Artis. Artis square, now puts it on the floor in the paint. A lot of arc, but won't fall. It's good follow by Artis as she kind of got a piece of it, and it was Bauer fumbling it away out of bounds, so it'll be Coon Rapids basketball one more time.
Well, the Cardinals like a basket here. They don't want to fall too far behind the Bengals.
Hatworth for three, that won't fall. And rebound out off the Cardinals.
Artis tried to sneak underneath there and get that offensive rebound, but not able to hang on to the basketball.
Erickson up court with an 11-5 lead. The shot hit the bottom of the backboard for Honey, and Cardinals turned it over at the other end, or did it go off of Blaine?
It went
it
off
did
the Bengals.
Go off the
yeah.
Bengals.
One of the things the Bengals have been trying to do is cut down on unforced errors. And early on, they've done a nice job of that here against Coon Rapids.
Artis with a good drive, able to score and break up the Blaine run. Good baseline move, but too much on it. Second chance wouldn't fall for Jordan Anderson. Artis has the rebound, and Coon Rapids will go to the other end. Hetwer underneath, Hanneman spins and scores, and it's back to a two-point game.
Well, Hetwer with a beautiful assist underneath the basket, just realizing the Hanneman there. Quick pass, gets the easy two, cuts the lead to two.
Erickson trying to get closer to the basket. And the hold on Berkland-Dixon.
Carver's going to check back in as well as Bohr for the Bengals. There's Red, number one fan.
Brought us Christmas cards.
That was so
very
nice.
Very, very nice.
Very gesture. Thoughtful.
Spin to the basket, didn't go for Anderson. Hanneman on the run the other way, gets it to Artis. Artis will pull up and roll it across the top of the iron. Out of bounds, off Coon Rapids.
9-11. Funny, the score, the time is 9-11 and the score is 9-11. Interesting. Boys and girls, how often does that happen?
Air ball goes off the Bengals underneath. And Coon Rapids will benefit from the turnover. Erickson's going to check back in for the Bengals. Artis pressured by Erickson. Pony there as well, gets it ahead for Hanneman. Carver in the corner, down low, post is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. Bohr will pick up the first Bengal infraction of this first half.
Yeah, they've gone.
More than 9 minutes.
Yeah, they've gone a while without committing any infractions and getting the opportunity to put anybody to the line. Cardinals have taken advantage of it.
Post. Can't get the first one to go. But is able to hit the second. Tipped away as they tried to get Honey running to the baseline.
One of the ugly sweaters in attendance here tonight. I hope I'm not offending him by saying his sweater is ugly, but it is.
Coach Deb Peterson rocking hers.
Oh, she's got a great one. The lights up and everything. I had an Impeach Nixon
staff.
Sweater back in the day that lit up.
Long two won't go for Honey. Rebound batted around. What a strip by Post while she's on her back, but the Cardinals then throw it away, and Hanneman's going to get called for the foul. Nice job by the freshman on the floor, able to come away with that steal, but Bohr got position on the pass, unfortunately.
Well, that's going to be Laney's second foul, team fifth. So Coach Peterson have to keep an eye on her and make sure that she's not in foul trouble.
When she comes off the floor.
Just as I said that.
Bohr working against Artis. Hands off for Honey going the other way. Erickson on the right side now. She'll get to the lane, lost the handle, out of bounds, Coon Rapids ball.
Yeah, good tight cast is what I said. When it was 11-5, I just talked about the fact that they need to keep it close, and they have. They've been able to cut into that and limit what Blaine wants to do offensively and able to get 5 points.
Artis comes across center court as Erickson awaits. Tried to set up the screen and she lost the handle. It was over and back. She's almost better letting the Blaine player touch it and then trying to steal it back.
Yep.
Inbounded to Anderson, gives it back to Erickson, splits a couple of defenders, can't get it to fall. Post has the rebound, and here's Hatwer up floor. Cardinals with the numbers, tried the bounce pass, didn't get through to Carver, and it's carried out of bounds by Honey, so Coon Rapids basketball.
Well, again, good thought by Coon Rapids, trying to use Ellie's size underneath. Cardinals going to call another timeout. Coach Pearson wants to talk about things. Is trailing by a point with 7:18 remaining in the opening half. You know, Coach Pearson said one thing we need to do is we need to get tougher on both ends of the court. We have to use sometimes our size advantage to control what's going on underneath, and that's something that's also been lacking a little bit for the Cardinals so far in this season.
There's that sweater for Coach Pearson.
Yeah, we can't see it lighting up though. We have to get a shot of that. How do people watch a game if they want to watch a game, Joanne, that we do? How is that possible?
Radio?
It could be radio, telegraph.
How about YouTube?
YouTube, that works.
You can get the app on your phone and everything.
Look at there we are, right on somebody's
CTN
phone.
CTN Studios or CTN Coon Rapids. On YouTube.
Yeah, you can watch us wherever
you
go. Get
in with all the fun.
Yeah, wherever you go.
Carver will get it back for Artis. A little more than 7 minutes remaining. First half, Artis kicks it out. Dixon, long two, missed everything. Post had the rebound, then got her shot swatted away by Erickson. Here's Post for three. That's short, and Blaine has numbers. Erickson has the rebound. And the Bengals head up court. Dixon knocked it away, but second chance commits the foul. Her first, team sixth.
Yeah, so
no, it's her second.
Her second. Yeah, this is the Cardinals one away from the bonus situation for the Bengals.
Erickson right side for Honey. And a travel as Bauer tried to give it back to her. So I think two teams with far more turnovers than they had hoped when this began a little more than 11 minutes ago.
Yeah, and I had mentioned earlier that the Bengals
Dixon
working on
underneath.
That.
Carver can't finish. Post second chance won't go. Rebound out of bounds. And Bauer had, Bohr had touched it.
Now just a little bit too much on that underneath for Ellie Carver.
Well, Nicole Post getting a few rebounds in her time off the bench. Now isolated in the post, draws the foul. She'll go to the line again.
I think that's on Bohr. That's her second. Nope. Could be on Erickson. It's quiet in here.
Post able to hit the first, tie it up. Second one won't fall. Rebound controlled by Garfield. Oh. Hatwer got a piece of the pass and
nice
knocked
hustle.
It out of bounds.
Nice hustle by Hatwer. Not able to control it, but got a piece of it. Let's the Blaine player know that she's there.
Yeah, Carson gets in, blocked by Hanneman. Bohr, an open look for three. That's short. Rebound tracked down by Hetwer. Now pushes it ahead for Carver. Carver's shot rolls over the top. Garfield pushing it back the other way. Erickson will get down low, get the foul on Hetwer, and get two shots. Erickson able to hit the first, put the Bengals back in front. She also misses one of two. Tie up on the rebound means playing basketball.
Now Bengals able to do a good job underneath.
Garfield's pass was deflected by Dixon, but got up top to Carson, and now Erickson sets the offense, and that's a moving screen. That'll be number two on Bohr.
Yeah, we'll see if she comes out in this situation. Yeah, she's coming out. Brian's coming in. So she comes out of the lineup with her, those two personals, and that's a good place for her in terms of if you're a Coon Rapids fan, you'd like her off the court. She's a very good basketball player.
Down to the baseline for Dixon, turns away from the pressure by Erickson. Hetwer up top, across for Artis. Dixon working against Erickson, able to get around her, but stripped by Garfield. Carson running the other way. Put it up, rebound tipped. Hetwer has it. Ahead for Carver. Dixon able to finish off the glass, and the Cardinals have the lead.
Carver unselfish, able to find Dixon underneath. Delivers the pass for the bucket by Dixon. Her first 2 points of the game.
Block.
Not my house.
By Ellie Carver.
With Post and Hanneman and Carver in there, the Cardinals have some nice size.
Power is not able to power her way home that time. But the Bengals still have possession. Erickson faces up against Hetwer. Spins to her right, shot partially deflected. Power gets the rebound. Three-pointer won't go for Carson. Rebound tipped, and Hetwer has it on the run. She's got Post with her, the two freshmen. Unfortunately, the pass kind of handcuffed Post down in her feet. Carson left side for Erickson. And now Carson has it again on the right side. Into the corner for Erickson. Hanneman nearly got there, but she's going to pick up the foul.
Will that be her third? That'll be her third. Yeah, she's got to come out. That's unfortunate. Just came back in and
those long arms of hers were just an inch longer, she might have had the tip ball and created the turnover instead. She has to take a seat. Erickson hits the first. We're back to even at 11 all. And And she'll only hit 50% again this time. Hatworth screaming down the lane. She was, she missed, but post another offensive board and draws the foul.
Well, yeah, I mean, just good hustle on the offense by Post, just following her.
And good recognition from Hetwer to sprint down court.
Yep.
And a good look from Brooklyn Dixon, and it all started with the rebound by Ellie Carver.
Carver tried to find Post underneath, a little bit too much on it. Again, some of the fans here saying for Ellie to take that shot.
Garfield will.
I mean, she's averaging 15 points a night.
Only give it back to Bauer.
Yet to score.
Carson baseline runner is good.
Yeah, nice job. A little floater up and over Carver. Give the Bengals the 2-point lead with 2:45 remaining in the opening half.
Dixon in the corner, watched by Garfield. Will put it up for three, misses everything, and Bauer has the rebound off the backside.
Again, you know, being able to get those looks inside, being able to get your baskets to fall, your shots to fall.
And another foul on the Cardinals. It'll be a 1-1 opportunity for Garfield.
Dixon, that'd be her third. So now two Cardinals with three personals here in this first half.
Ashley Flatham will check in.
And you got to remember, you're missing Courtney and Caitlin Ackerman here tonight. Two key contributors for the Cardinals. I think they're watching the game from their crews.
Perhaps. Garfield hits them both. As we approach 2 minutes remaining in the first half, it's a 4-point lead for Blaine. Handed off to Flatham up top. And now Hetworth. Hetworth trying to cross over against Bauer. Now Artis on the left side. Artis splits a couple of defenders. Flatham tried to get it low to Carver. And it's turned over back to Blaine.
And she had a look at the basket, but decided to try to deliver it to Ellie underneath.
Brian with it high on the left side. Rapid sticking with a man on defense. Driving is Carson. She draws the contact. Artis going to be the guilty party this time. It'll be two shots.
That'll be her second.
It was a really clean game for the first half of this first half. But a lot of fouls of late for Coon Rapids. Bengals trying to make him pay.
Yeah, giving them opportunities at the line, and they're hitting their shots for the most part.
Carson able to hit both.
She has seven.
Lead is six. Largest so far as we're down to 1:15 remaining first half. Artis hands off for Hetworth. Hetworth down low, Post in the corner. Cross court, not enough on it, batted away. Artis able to recover in the backcourt, but then lost the handle out of bounds. Into the backcourt for Garfield. She'll bring it across against Hetworth. Stop up and leave it back for Bauer. Right side is Honey. Honey tried to sneak it back into the lane. Artis will get the steal and then get it away from her backside. And they will get it down court. Flatham back up top to Artis. And she'll get it back again from Hetworth. She'll back out 30 seconds. Post in the corner, down low for Carver. Spins off the glass and in.
Yeah, that's what they needed. They need to be able to work that ball in low. Ellie Carver, that time, doing a nice job converting.
Her first points of this first half as we're under 15 seconds remaining. Carson wanted a foul on the contact. The bump from Artis wouldn't get it. But the Bengals will keep possession.
4 seconds remain.
Carson just threw it up. She didn't realize how little time was and still almost made it. It'll be a 19-15 lead as we hit the break. We'll take a break. Be back with more Cardinal basketball on CTN after this.
How can I help my daughter with her reading?
Searching for help with Dachshund reading.
No.
Let me try. Sarah's bright, but when she's reading, she has trouble sounding out words.
Playing world music.
What?
I give up.
Wait, I was trying to show you how Sarah feels every day. Frustrating, isn't it? Redirecting to understood.org.
Join parents and experts at understood.org, a free online resource about learning and attention issues to help your child thrive.
Halftime at the Big House. Roger E. Carlson hasn't seen a lot of scoring.
Have not.
Just 34 combined points between the Bengals and the Cardinals as we get to the locker room. Both teams have shown flashes. A couple of three-pointers for the Cardinals in the first half. But Blaine did lead most of the way. 6 of their 19 came from the free throw line, most of that late, as the Cardinals will have to go the remainder of the game with some key pieces already in a little bit of concern for fouls. 3 fouls in the first half on 2 of their starters.
Yeah, and that may play down the stretch to be an important piece here, as you talked about it, and an opportunity for the Cardinals that, you know, they're lacking a few players as it is, and for them not to have that depth, that will play important here as this game continues on in the second half.
Well, it's anybody's game when we tip it off for half number 2. That'll come up next on CTN.
Looking for a new home? Come to Coon Rapids. Down payment assistance is available from the Mortgage Assistance Foundation when you purchase your new home with an FHA 203K mortgage. Any single family home in need of renovation or rehab can qualify. Find out more today. Call 763-767-6422 or visit the city's website.
We love our new home.
Back at the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse. Just about ready to get the second half underway. Blaine with a 4-point lead. And they will get the opening possession.
Yeah, we'll see what kind of adjustments both coaches made in between the break. Low scoring first half. A lot of turnovers. Some sloppy play in that first half. I'm sure both teams want to clean that up.
Inbound goes to Artis in the backcourt. She'll come across, met by Phoebe Carson, hands off to Hetworth. Trying to feed underneath, swatted away by Bohr, out of bounds.
The Cardinals like to get a score here in this possession.
Hetworth had Dixon cutting across the baseline, but Bohr denies the pass. in to Carver, leaves it off for Hanneman off the glass and in.
Yeah, nice drive by Hanneman, realized that she was tied up defensively, able to find Hanneman coming to the basket.
Brian thought about it and then passes it off. Little pump fake by Garfield. She'll get to the lane, lost the handle a little bit as she went up, and Carver has the rebound.
And that's what they're looking for, those defensive rebounds from Carver.
Artis misses the shot. Bengals end up with the rebound. Bohr can't control the pass, able to spin it across for Carver. Carson is fouled on the baseline.
Both Hanneman and Dixon maybe have to be a little bit cautious here in the second half.
That is Hanneman getting her fourth.
Oh, it was on Hanneman.
We won't see
her
until very late.
Yeah. And that's something the Cardinals could not afford to happen. A quick foul on Hanneman to start in the second half, and she will come out. And it takes an important player averaging a little over 8 points a night out of your lineup.
Carson misses the second, tracked down by Bohr, and she travels trying to get around Carver. Pass tipped and doesn't get through to post. Brian recovers, and now Garfield will bring it up court for the Bengals. Foul
That's
against
gonna be a
Artis.
Dixon. Oh, it's Artis. Like you saw, the Cardinals getting foul trouble in that first half. Already two here in the second half.
Garfield steps in. Her jump shot won't go. Post can't control the rebound. Knocked down. Does go off the Cardinals last. Lexi West will cheat. Get on the floor for the Cardinals.
I think Lexi was one of those players that was not feeling good the last few days and missed that game against Champlin Park.
Bohr driving around post. West made her change at the last moment. Bohr gonna be called for the push.
That'll be her third. So she's gonna have to sit.
Down low to Carver. Her shot partially deflected by Haney. And another foul.
On post, I think, this time. That'll be her first team third.
Garfield. Up top for Bohr, right side for Bryant. Really Babcock didn't see any time in the first half and to start the second. And a good steal underneath by Brooklyn Dixon.
Yeah, that's what they need. They need those turnovers. They need those defensive turnovers. And they need to make points from those turnovers.
Call foul away from it.
Oh, another one on post.
Nicole Post.
Her second team fourth, Kennedy Kerr coming in. And I think she was also another, that second player who was not feeling well.
Babcock, left side for Bryant. Three-pointer won't fall for Bohr. Kerr tracks it down in the corner, guarded by Garfield. Lost the handle a little bit, able to recover and ahead for Dixon. High post, Carver turns and looks, trying to go across to Kerr, batted away out of bounds by Anna Garfield. Dixon trying to make her way around Babcock, but not able to do so. Carver down low off the bottom of the backboard, got it back, and got it back to Dixon. Post back to Carver in the corner. Now Dixon stepping in. Her shot well off the mark, long rebound, controlled by Carson on the run. Carson will get the foul against West and get herself back to the free throw line.
And that puts Coon Rapids with 14:45 remaining in the second half at five personals as a team. Cardinals are going to call a timeout here, trailing by three. They have a couple players in foul trouble for Coon Rapids, most notably Lane Hanneman with four. Red's in the house. Red getting a shout out from Tommy Glines.
Tommy G,
class of 73.
It's a good year, 73.
Fine year.
14:45 remaining in this second half. And we got a close one.
We do.
Carson hit one of two earlier in the half. Able to hit the first one here.
Yeah, free throw is so important. She has nine, looking for her 10th point here.
And Carson hits them both.
Nothing but net.
Phoebe Carson leading all scorers. On the run, Post can't get it to roll home.
Yeah, again, finishing. She can't get it to finish. We've seen a number of plays like that this evening for the Cardinals. Just not being able to finish in close.
Garfield to the floor, has to stop up, kick it back to Brian up top. 5-point lead for the Bengals, open look, Carson for three, and she nailed it.
Yeah, again, spotting up, defense not coming out and challenging. She's able to drop it.
She has all six Bengal points early in this second half, and their lead as large as it's been all game at 8 points. Inbound goes to Hetwer. West trying to drive, her shot blocked. Battle for the ball won by Brian.
Post was fortunate she didn't pick up a foul there.
Babcock driving, swatted away by Carver, and then tipped it to Post. Dixon has to watch her back. Babcock's there, 15-foot jumper for Carver. Rattled around and out. West able to punch it back to Hetwer, who knocks down the jump shot.
Again, you get that second opportunity, and Hetwer doing a nice job of dropping it. 25-19, in favor of the Bengals.
Three-pointer around and out for Madison Haney, and the rebound by Dixon. West three-pointer won't go. Dixon got there late, hit the floor hard, and is going to end up with the foul for her trouble.
Yeah, her fourth. Team sixth.
Kennedy Kerr and Destiny Artis will check back in as Dixon heads to the bench for a while, I would assume.
Yeah.
And Hetwer will get a breather.
Now you have two starters with four personals here, 12:38 remaining.
8-point lead, Babcock crosses over, and then the pass is behind Carson. And a turnover back to the Cardinals. West gets it into Artis.
Oh, almost a great save.
Well, you gotta let it go.
I thought it went off of her, though.
Uh-uh. Mm-hmm. I don't think so.
I thought it did. And that's why she was saving it.
I mean,
oh no, I don't know if it went off her hand there after it was knocked away. That's what I thought, but I could be wrong. I'm old.
I think you let that one go and hope.
Hope and pray that it's
that
off.
The ref decides that it was off the defensive player who tipped it free. Post able to get a good rebound underneath. Artis across midcourt. Hands off to Lexi West, back up top. They're gonna call the foul against.
Really? Coach Peterson's not happy with that.
See that she stepped out, the post stepped out just before the contact, and the contact was hard.
Huh.
Post got a hand in, nearly tipped it away there for Bauer. And she's got to play a little more, a little careful now. Three fouls, didn't have any in her first half. Bauer shot off the glass and in.
Yeah, Bauer doing a nice job of gaining the edge and able to put the little floater up. 27-19.
Artis to post. Kerr on the right side. Comes to the lane and traveled.
Yeah.
Good hand by Babcock to tie her up. I like the specs on Babcock.
I do
it's
as well.
It's got a very
old school feel to it.
Kurt Rambis feel.
Yeah, old school.
By the Bengals as they were approaching 5 seconds.
Yeah, they wanted to make sure they held possession of the basketball, so a good timeout. By Coach Brewston.
Get that homework done.
You gotta get your homework done for sports night. I'm not sure when we're doing it this week. We talked about maybe doing it on Tuesday.
I believe it's gonna
be Tuesday.
I think
it's gonna be Tuesday.
Afternoon-ish.
Holiday course is Monday. Wishing everybody a happy, Merry Christmas, safe Christmas. And Joe, I hope you get what you asked Santa for.
Peace on earth.
Nice.
Goodwill toward men.
I asked for a bag full of money.
I've asked for that so many times.
No, it's like getting old.
I never get it.
I only get bills in the mail. It's like, why can't I get checks in the mail? Stepped out.
Because you're the star of Sports Night and not Sports Center.
That's true.
But that's all right with us.
I'm happy.
Okay. I was going to say, you know, the little bumps, you need to call them against the Bengals. Cardinals have gotten a lot of those bumps, and I think that was what had Coach Peterson so upset, is that, you know, they were getting called for everything. Although Post, I thought that was a good call. It was It looked a lot more dramatic, though. Artis down low, Carver turns and scores.
Yeah, and again, that's what they been looking to do all evening. They wanted to take advantage of that post game underneath with Ellie Carver and, of course, Lainey Hanneman, who's been in foul trouble, haven't been able to use her skills out there for a while. Just 4 points for Carver, who's averaging 15 on the evening, I mean on the season.
Another turnover by the Bengals. Pushed ahead for Artis on the left side, nearly lost it, able to regain control, find a little room. Short jumper won't fall though, rebound tipped. Kerr gets it from just inside the free throw line, won't fall. Saved by Babcock, and it sends Bauer on the run the other way. She can't finish, Kerr is crashed into.
It's gonna be on Carson, I believe.
Yeah, her second in a row, and both times she is appealed with outstanding body language.
Who, me? What did I do? And the Cardinals are fortunate they didn't turn the ball over there.
Bauer just couldn't control as she tried to cut it off at center court. Destiny Artis, her pass taken away by Bauer, and Bauer has it on the run. Artis got up and got the block.
Nice job, all ball for Destiny Artis.
Good recovery after the turnover, but what hustle by Bauer. Couple of plays in a row, she missed the steal and made sure on the second time. And Carson definitely held as she tried to get to the lane. Hetwer picking up her second. Eighth on the Cardinals, so a 1-1 chance for Carson.
Kayla Bohr back in with her three personals. And she's averaging, we talked about she's averaging 11, just 5 points on the evening as she's been sitting on the bench a little bit.
Rebound by Carver. Hetwer. Get it back up top for Artis, and now back to Hetwer. Artis working against Carson, trying to hand off to Kerr. They turn it over, Bauer on the run again. And this time she finishes.
Yeah, she had enough space between her and a defender, a trailer, that she's able to not rush her shot and finish and get the basket. Now turnover there. And Artis is gonna pick it up.
Carson's gonna go back to the line.
You know, these are obviously important free throws for the Bengals. They want to increase this lead.
Carson misses the first. Get the roll that time.
Kiana Erickson back in for the Bengals. Carson will take a seat on the bench. 14 points on the night.
Dixon had to go up to get the inbound pass, and then drives. Carver comes up short, and then Garfield dribbled on the line. Just over 9 minutes remaining. Midway through this second half, and foul's gonna be called underneath as Brian defending on Ellie Carver.
And Brian's first personal, fourth team on the Bengals.
Dixon now, up top to Hetworth. Back down low, Carver turns and scores.
Again, nice force underneath the middle, and again, using that size ability and that force underneath getting the bucket. She now has six.
Hetworth got a hand on it, got the steal, gets it up court to Lainey Hanneman. Hanneman able to score on the fast break.
Yeah, that's what you want. You want to convert turnovers to points. The Cardinals did a great job at that. Hetwer with the steal and the nice quick pass to Hanneman, and she finishes. 8 points for Lainey Hanneman on the night.
Jumper for Bohr is short. Good box out by West, and Bohr's going to get the foul.
Yeah, that'll be her fourth. And she'll come out.
Well defended by Lexi West. And Bohr not happy to be headed back to the bench.
Nope. You have four personals. Your coach is going to let you sit and think about it for a while. Carver coming out of the game.
Hanneman playing a little smaller with the four fouls for the Cardinals. Inbound to Dixon. Right back to Lexi West on the run. Left side pass taken away again by Bauer. Emily Bauer's had a really nice second half for the Bengals. Haney up top for Garfield. Back to Bauer. Bounce pass. The drive, and who is the foul going to go on? Foul's going to go against Lexi West.
That'll be her second.
Going to put Avery Powers at the line. First one rolls in.
She gets the nice bounce off the rim.
And she hits the second one cleanly. Back to a 7-point lead, just under 8 minutes remaining. Hanneman slows it down, back for Dixon. Able to get around Erickson. Hanneman long too. That won't go. West has the rebound. Battles way underneath. Her shot blocked. And Bauer traveled. Good step up by Hetwer to force the turnover.
Hetwer's having a nice game here. She's got five points, but defensively she's playing really well.
She's been impressive. Yep. And just a freshman again.
Exactly.
And Nicole Post, a freshman, called in to play a lot of minutes.
Yep, always nice to see the future of the program.
Hanneman inside. Post was in traffic, couldn't control. Bauer on the run at the other end. That won't fall. Carver has the rebound. Up court to Dixon, not enough on it. Erickson nearly picked it off, but then Dixon recovers. Got it underneath to Post, goes to the floor, got it back to Dixon. Turned into traffic, back to Hanneman, and now Carver. Dixon, an open look for three. That won't fall. Post can't control, thought she got bumped, and she goes down. Numbers at the other end. Carson misses, Erickson doesn't.
You talked about numbers for Blaine at the other end. That easy basket for Erickson off the miss. 9-point lead for the Bengals with 6:45 remaining in this contest.
Hanneman will pull up and hit the jump shot.
Yeah, nice little jumper, just under control.
Carson driving and missing. Post the rebound. And then the foul is going to be called on Madison Haney.
That'll be her first, team's sixth. Nice job by Hanneman. Pull up jumper, able to get it to drop. She has 10 points, leading scorer for the Cardinals this evening.
Artis working against Carson, finds a little room, takes the jump shot off the glass and in.
That cuts the lead to 5.
Bauer along the baseline is bumped.
It's just,
and
just
it's step up out of bounds. Yep. No foul is called. Another steal by the Bengals on defense. Carson stops up. Bauer tried to get it to Haney and it's lost out of bounds. 5:39 remain.
Now that's
5-point lead for Blaine.
One of the things Coach Brewston talked to me about is unforced turnovers, just too many this year for the Bengals, and you saw another one there.
High post, Carver draws 3 Bengals, can't get the pass out. Erickson will lead the charge, now back out, now step back in. Little scoop won't fall, Carver has the rebound, and now Artis will carry it. Artis trying to get it to Lexi West, and it's kicked. Cardinals can reset.
Yeah, just a 5-point lead for the Bengals. Just Cardinals doing a good job just keeping it close, making sure they're staying in this contest.
West.
5 seconds.
Erickson able to get it in. Artis tipped it away, recovered by Haney. Now gets it to Bauer. That was over the back.
Yeah.
The fans knew it.
Officials didn't see it.
Cutting is Bauer, can't get it to fall. Post the rebound.
That time Post doing a nice job defensively on the board.
Coming back for it is Hanneman. Her turnaround jumper is good. And the lead is down to 3. And a travel. Dixon way up top for Artis. Carson nearly had a hand on it. Trying to feed it underneath to Post.
She can't control it. She's got a little, I don't know if she's got a little contact there, but can't control it.
Erickson into the front court. To Carson, she can't get it to go. A tie up, and the ball will go to Coon Rapids.
Well, again, just keeping this game close. 3-point lead for the Bengals. And the Cardinals, when Blaine turns the ball over, they'll try and continue to turn those opportunities into points.
Hanneman kicks it out, Artis for 3, won't go. Dixon hustles and gets the rebound back for the Cardinals.
Yeah, Dixon, nice job of tracking that ball down.
Dixon steps inside, can't get it to go, nearly at her own rebound. Still loose, Carver goes on the floor and grabs it, now tied up. And it'll be Bengal ball this time.
Yeah, good hustle, good thought by Ellie. Just possession arrow does go to the Bengals.
Babcock will slow back down. Guarded by Dixon, left side for Bryant. Will pump another. And now up top, Babcock for three. This won't fall. Post the rebound. She's got to be closing in on double-digit rebounds.
Yeah, she's been impressive. You know, we talked about her coming off the bench, and they're looking for quality minutes from her, and she's been giving them.
Turnaround won't fall. Erickson has the rebound, and
Post reached in.
Post's going to get called for the reach in. That'll be her fourth. And double bonus time for the Bengals. Erickson hit everything but the net. Jeff visited every part of the rim before heading out. Wow. That one stayed up there a long time and still didn't go down. Hanneman the rebound. Hetworth to Dixon, back to Hetworth. She'll fire the three, it's good! And we're all tied up.
Big shot from Hetworth from the outside. She has eight.
Mom knew it. Mom jumped to her feet and called it before it went through the cylinder. Bengals nearly cough it up again. Erickson walked, and they do. 2:20 remaining.
Now Boers back in with her four personals. You know, 2:20 left. You need that player in the game. She's good on both ends of the floor.
Full court pressure from Blaine. Artis trying to get around Garfield and does, and now we'll get a chance to set the Cardinals offense. She picked it up. She needs help. Carver at the top of the key, down low. Turning with it is Hanneman. Can't roll it across the top. Boer has the rebound. Carson backing away from Hetwer at the top of the key. Too tall for Erickson, and Coon Rapids will get another chance. Timeout, Cardinals. 1:49 to go.
Yeah, we have a nice game going here. Low scoring game, but a nice game going here nonetheless. A little sloppy, but at this point coming
contested.
In. Well, it is, and it's anybody's game with a minute 49, and that's what you want, whether you like what you're seeing all the time on the court, maybe not, but the fact is you've got a competitive game. I love it. Brandon Rickert's mustache, I gave him the Howie Shapiro starter kit. I like it, very nice. Look at that, debonair.
It's upside down.
It is upside down.
That's okay.
But Brandon's upside down.
Most of the time, there you go.
It's Snidely Whiplash. There we go.
If you don't know who that is, kids.
Look it up.
Google it.
At Brandon Rickert.
Red's having a good time.
You play it, Red.
He's a lefty. I had no idea. All right. Back to basketball as Hetworth gets it ahead for Dixon, and she'll bring it into the offensive end for Coon Rapids. Gets the screen from Carver. down into the corner. Artis trying to get to the baseline. Kicks it out. Hetworth for three again. That one had too much on it. Loose rebound. Controlled by Erickson. Garfield running the right side. And that's going to be number five on Laney Hanneman.
Yeah, just the reach in there. Cole Post will come in.
Couldn't stop her momentum.
Nope. And gonna fall out with a dozen. Nice hand for Laney Hanneman with her 12 points.
And that'll put Post back on the floor. She also has four. Garfield able to hit the free throw.
Well, it says she has four. Artis has four. Dixon has four, all three on the floor.
Coon Rapids had scored nine straight to tie it. And Carson hits them both.
Two big ones.
Garfield, rather, hits them both. Oh. Post can't quite get to it, and the Cardinals turn it over.
Yeah, a little bit too much on that pass from Dixon.
Carson to Bohr in the corner. Up top for Erickson. Watched by Artis. Gets it to Bohr on the right side. She'll put it on the floor. Back out. Garfield at the top of the key. And now Bohr and a timeout. Blaine. 102 on the clock.
Yeah, with the slimmest of leads, 2 points for the Bengals.
Coach Brewston didn't like Brewston, what he
nope.
saw.
Decided better want
Let's
to call
just
things.
Let's stop it right
yep.
there.
Yep, with possession, a minute two left.
This is a huge possession yep. for the Bengals. Both teams have turned the ball over far too much. But here you've got a chance to make it a two-possession game. You need to make this one count.
You do. There's
After giving up that big lead late in the game.
Well, if you like low-scoring contests, this is your game. Both teams struggling offensively, but it doesn't matter how many points you score. Whoever scores the most is the one that you want to obviously comes out on top.
Brian inbound for the Bengals, gets it to Erickson, and now Garfield. Puts it on the floor, working against Dixon. There's Erickson, watched by Hetworth. Brian on the right wing. Bohr at the top of the key, left side for Carson. Up top, Garfield, 45 seconds remain.
Yeah, they won't be in a hurry to get a shot off.
Well, if they're gonna shoot it
Carlos in, may have to foul.
And Dixon got a hand in. Brooklyn Dixon doesn't believe it.
Fans saying that the official was faked out.
Hard to see from that angle yeah. if she actually made contact, but the reaction by Garfield would definitely imply that she got poked. Misses the first. So it will be a one possession game.
Well, and the Cardinals, if this is missed, they make sure they need the rebound here.
She does make it. It's a 3-point lead with 36 seconds remaining.
And that was a big free throw. Now you have to hit one from beyond the arc if you want to tie it up. Unless you get a two and a foul.
I was going to say, or do you get down low, make it two, and get it back to a 1 point? There's still plenty of time.
Plenty.
Here. You definitely want that 2 points.
Yep.
Worry about the three. Artis scores it down low. Good sure. Shield down low by Post.
Yeah, nice job and
good position
the
by
Artis.
Post right there.
Yeah.
Getting her room to get to the baseline.
She made a count. Coach Brewston drawing out what he wants. Coach Peterson talking about to her squad about what we need to do with on defensive end with a 1-point deficit. Another partial sellout here at Roger E. Carlson. 307 here in the field house tonight. Not like the 700 we had for Joe Young bobblehead night.
Yeah, right.
But nice crowd nonetheless. Didn't you get that bobblehead?
Well, we ran out, and I wouldn't want to deprive the fans.
That's true. You should have lined down the block.
I got two Howie Shapiros.
For the price of one. They're on closeout.
Cardinals collapse. Plenty of contact there, but no foul. And
the
a timeout by Blaine. They were getting, you know, they were down in there for 7 seconds.
You see the time remaining, a little less than 13 seconds.
You definitely don't want to get the 10-second violation and turn it over that way.
Everybody having a good time at the ball game tonight. That's the Brandon Rickert fan club.
No, I'm not over there.
Oh, well, you're working, but I know you're there in spirit. The membership is growing in the Brandon Rickert fan club. It's up to 8. Well, counting you, it's 9.
I'm the president. That's right. I'm not only the president, I'm also a member.
You have a gavel with a mustache on it, ain't it?
10 seconds. She gets across midcourt. They've got the numbers. And the foul called before the shot. West will get the foul. Carson will go to the free throw line. 3 seconds remaining. I think Deb's asking why. This should have been a foul way back here. There's still 17 seconds left on the clock. So Carson can only make it a 2-point game. And she missed. Post to Artis from half court. Will not make it, and the Bengals will hold on for a 1-point victory.
Yeah, tough loss for Coon Rapids, a low-scoring contest, a lot of mistakes by both teams. And unfortunately for the Cardinals, they're on the wrong end of a 37-36 Blaine victory. Blaine will move to 5-4. Cardinals will drop to 3-5 on the season.
Take a short break. We'll be back, wrap things up from Roger E. Carlson right after this. Back at the Roger E. Carlson Fieldhouse, a 1-point victory for the Blaine Bengals. It came down to the very end. The Bengals had a 9-point lead late in the half. Coon Rapids able to erase it with a 9-0 run. even things up with for the final 2 minutes, but Blaine holds on at the very end.
You're losing your mustache a little bit, but nonetheless, yeah, it was a tough loss for the Cardinals, and they had that opportunity to win foul trouble for a number of Cardinal players, and it's an opportunity here for Coon Rapids to learn from that, but they would have loved to have got that win on their home court.
Absolutely, and you're talking about a team that is down a couple of starters who are out of town on vacation as we get to the holiday break, and some younger players getting an opportunity and stepping up well. The two freshmen tonight were really quite impressive for Coon Rapids. Both Kylie Hetwer and Nicole Post played a lot of minutes tonight and had good results. And, you know, the Ackerman sisters, when they return from vacation, might have a little more competition for floor time the rest of the way.
Well, if nothing else, it just adds to your depth, and how important is that as the season progresses. You've got some kids coming off the bench now have a lot of confidence as they continue on in this season, because if called upon, that Coach Pearson knows that they can perform.
Well, that half-court heave by Destiny Artis, of course, not anywhere close, but Coon Rapids, you know, give them credit. It was not the game they wanted to play, and things did not go their way. And Blaine had a big lead, but they stuck with it, stuck to their game plan, got some more things to happen. And Hanneman came in and played some really good minutes with those four fouls in the second half and really led that charge that got him back to a tie game with 2 minutes left.
Yeah, unfortunately fouling out and not being able to be in there at the end of that game. But you give both teams credit. It's, you know, it's a low-scoring contest. Both teams committing turnovers, both teams a little sloppy play. And for the Bengals, they hit that free throw at the end to get that one-point opportunity.
Yeah, and we get to take a short holiday break, but we have a lot more coming up for you next week on Sports Night. Girls hockey, the Cardinal Cup outdoors on the CTN Sports Rink.
It's going to be fun.
The CTN Outdoor Rink. It's beautiful.
It is beautiful. Three nights of hockey
for us. We will have
us.
Three nights in a row right here for you on CTN. But that is going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score, Blaine 37, Coon Rapids 36. Want to thank everybody out there for joining us, continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. Want to wish everyone a happy and safe holidays. And for all of us, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young, saying goodnight.
Merry Christmas, senor.